टर्म वन चल रहा है ना, यू वॉन्ट टू डू रिडॉक्स रिएक्शन? मोहम्मद अमर, कैन यू प्लीज स्पीक?
यस सर,
नहीं तो रिडॉक्स रिएक्शन इज इन टर्म वन ना?
ओके
हाँ
ओके, आई वाज जस्ट आस्किंग इफ यू विल डू इट अलोंगसाइड द
या आई विल बी डूइंग द टर्म वन. सो टर्म वन में आप लोग का भी स्टेट्स ऑफ मैटर चल रहा है, राइट?
इन टर्म टू.
नो, टर्म टू स्टेट्स ऑफ मैटर. टर्म वन यू हैव केमिकल बॉन्डिंग, यस ना? Yes, so after finishing chemical bonding, we will be doing organic chemistry and then we will be doing redox reaction. Or do you guys want redox reaction? Pehle? I do, I mean, no, na? Redox reaction. Also see, redox reaction and hydrogen, they are very small chapters, okay? And many portion from redox reaction has been removed. I mean, see, there is oxidation and reduction balancing of redox reaction. And there are a few tough portions that I will say, comparatively tough portions, which are removed. Okay, for example, application of redox reaction is not there.
Sir,
mm-hmm.
Will we be able to understand this chapter without learning redox reaction and hydrogen?
Yeah, you can. Because this chapter is related to, let me tell you, you will be not needing the chapter 3, 2, 3 and 4. So 2, 3 and 4 will not be needed, but you will be needing the chapter 1. I mean, number of moles. The mole concept will be used here, okay? And will be very much used.
Okay.
So states of matter, you know, states of matter. Initially, we started with what? Initially, we started in chapter 1. We learned about what? We learned about atoms and molecules, and not the chemistry of atoms and molecules, but the physics of atoms and molecule and the mass of atoms and molecule, in the sense that what mass will be, masses of, we learned about masses, we learned about volume, right? We learned about what the concentration, the amounts, right? We also learned how these atoms behave if they are, how the molecules behave. For example, if you have carbon and you have oxygen molecule, then how will they behave? They will form CO2. If you have CH4 and then you have O2, then we learned that they will, what they will do, a reaction here and here, they will form CO2 and water. And then we have to always write the stoichiometric coefficient. We have to balance these things. Okay. Now what we are going to, so these were individual atoms and individual molecules. So all the properties, was only dependent on what molecule is there and what are the elements inside that molecule. So we have constricted ourselves into what molecules, but you will never get one molecule of carbon dioxide. You will never get one molecule of H2O, right? So whenever you will be working on any substance, that substance will have a number of molecules, and it will be having a number of elements and atoms present in it. So there are something which is known as, molecular properties. Molecular property. For example, what will be the bond strength? Regarding bond strength, bond angle, right? And what is the electronegativity? What is the atomic radius? All these are molecular and atomic properties, okay, elemental properties. And there are something which is known as bulk properties. Bulk property. Now, this bulk property are different things, right? The bulk properties are different things. So, for example, bulk property will be pressure of a gas. Then you can have mass, right? Mass of a particular thing. Then you can also have what? The volume. Okay, so these are what, these are bulk properties that we'll be learning. So we'll be mainly concerned about the bulk property. Now, let us just, so a bulk means there are a group of molecules, right? There are a group of molecules and there are a group of elements. Yes or no?
Yeah.
Yes, gang? Okay, so humans are also made up of what? Atoms and groups. That is why you will see the analogy is not, humans and gases and molecules, everything, it will be very similar. Now, if you are measuring yourself in individual capacity, then what are the things you will be measuring yourself with? You will be measuring yourself with how much focus you can have, right? Then you will be measuring yourself that what is your attention span, right? What is your attention span? Then you can also measure for how many hours can you sit for study? How many hours can you sit? But the things that you measure for being a good candidate changes if you are in a group. So if you are in a group, they will see that whether you are a team worker or not. Okay. Whether you can work in teams or not, whether you are a good leader or not. So the properties there also changes, and you will see that how you behave in a individual situation, it is vastly different how you behave in a group. Yes or no? How you behave in a group, correct? Now the behavior of individuals, it does not truly represents the behavior of group. Okay, now let us think about some schools. Okay, so Reba, I forgot your school's name. What is your school?
Alalia
school. So Alalia school is there is the Indian International Schools, right? So there is also a notion about those schools, yes or no? Like wahan aise bachche hote hain, yahan aise bachche hote hain, yes or no?
Yes,
right? Now do you think that truly represent what each and every individual will be like that, or the individual will be something different? No, na? The individual will be something different, but as a group they portray some different picture or some another picture. So that is why, what do we do? There are some properties that we measure, right? There are some group properties, the bulk properties, which we say the bulk properties. And obviously this bulk property will depend on how the individuals interact, right or not. This is the main thing in a group, because if there is no interaction, there is no group. That means the most important point when you are learning about any group is what, how are they interacting? Okay. How are they interacting with each other? And similarly in chemistry also, when you are studying about atoms and molecules which are in a group, then you have to look at the interactions. You have to look at what? We have to look at interactions. Okay. So when you have humans, then we say it is human interaction. Okay. That is human interaction which is happening. And if you have molecules, then we say it is molecular interaction. And specifically speaking, it will be what? Intermolecular interaction. Please write intermolecular interactions or forces. Okay, intermolecular interaction or intermolecular forces. I will generally refer this as IMF. I will generally represent this as IMF. Now, whenever you will have two atoms or two molecules, this is A and this is B. In chemistry, you can only have two forces. Okay, there's force here. There can be only two forces. That is, either it will be attraction, or this will be repulsion, or this will be repulsion. We will be mainly focusing on the attraction. There will be some where you will have repulsion, and then you will see that, and we will distinguish where there will be repulsion, where there will be attraction. But we will be mainly focusing on what, attractive forces. Okay, attractive forces, and that is what derives the whole states of matter chapter, intermolecular interaction or forces, IMF. Now, if you can have what? You can have high attraction. Let us say you have high, there will be medium, and there will be negligible. So we say they is a substance you can classify according to the intermolecular interaction or forces of attraction. Okay, so we are classifying all these substances based on what? Intermolecular interaction or forces of attraction. So if there is very high, very large force of attraction between the, now you say, see, inter school competition. Do you guys have inter school competitions?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So how many school participate in that? Many schools, right?
Yes,
more than one, at least more than one, correct?
Yes.
Right. So whenever you will have intermolecular interaction, now there should be always more than one molecule. Can you guys remember this? Yes or no?
Yes.
Can all of you remember? Okay. So intermolecular interaction, what will happen? You will have more than one molecule. So if there are more than one molecule, and those molecules, they have between them a large force of attraction, a large force of attraction. For example, you have H2O molecule. Now there is another H2O molecule. So let us say this is H2O molecule, this is another H2O molecule, and there will be some interaction here happening. And there is a large force of attraction between these two molecules. Okay, between these two molecules, let us say. Okay. So next example can be, if you have medium, force of attraction, I will write it as FOA. and there will be negligible FOA, force of attraction. Now, if you have very large force of attraction, that will lead to these molecules which will stick together like this. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
They will be very close. They will be very close to each other. Now, this is what? This is an example of solid. This is what? This will form solid. So, solid is what? Solid is very, solid is something which has very large intermolecular force of attraction. Now, same thing can be present, and if the molecule they have less force of attraction, then it will be something like this. Okay, so as you can see, there is no shape here. There is no definite shape. You cannot predict where the other atom will be. And similarly, you can also have. Negligible forces of attraction. Here the atoms, they will have very so this is what this is. Let me add just a few more. This is liquid and this is gas. Done?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So solid has very large force of attraction. Then liquid has medium force of attraction. And the gases have negligible forces of attraction. Now, after this, what we have to study is what are these forces of attraction? Like there is some force of attraction between the molecules, right? Between the molecule, there is some force of attraction, but what are these forces of attraction? So please write the intermolecular forces. Intermolecular forces. There are 4 IMF. How many? There are 4 IMF. The first is dipole-dipole interaction. After dipole-dipole interaction, we will learn about dipole-induced dipole. Dipole-induced dipole. Now, after dipole-induced dipole, we will learn about London forces or dispersion forces. London forces or dispersion forces. And at last, we will be learning about hydrogen bond. Assalamualaikum Umar, how are you? And obviously these intermolecular forces, these are not like chemical bonds. They are not very strong forces. Okay, they are not very strong forces. They are weak forces. So write 2 points here. These are weak forces. Another point is that These were first discussed by van der Waal. Hence, these are also known as, these are AKA van der Waal forces. These are also known as van der Waals forces. Write this down, let me know if you're done.
Also, can you scroll up a little bit?
Yeah, sure. Umar, can you please write when I am not explaining? I'm obviously not explaining anything here, okay? So please write with me. You can even just listen and write. You don't need to see the screen.
Okay, so you can proceed.
The first intermolecular force that we'll understand is dipole-dipole interaction. Dipole-dipole interaction. Okay. Now, in dipole-dipole interaction, we will start with an example. We'll understand what is this, how it is arising, and then we will define it. Okay. So you have HCl. Now, please, no one will write here. You have HCl. Okay. Now, can I talk about intermolecular forces of attraction if I have only one HCl? Yes or no, guys? Can we talk about intermolecular forces if we have only one HCl?
Yes.
Yes, sir. No.
Yes. No.
No. No.
आप लोग स्कूल खोलिएगा, अपने स्कूल में कंपटीशन कराइएगा, बोलिएगा इंटरमॉलिक्यूलर इंटर स्कूल कंपटीशन हो रहा है. हाँ. नो ना. यस. इफ यू हैव ओनली वन molecule, you will never talk about intermolecular forces, okay? You will always have to have another molecule. So let us take HCl, another HCl molecule, and let us see what is the interaction here. What is the interaction here? Okay. Now, to get what type of interaction will be there, we have to look inside each of these. We have to look inside each of these things, okay? Each of these things. So, in hydrogen and fluorine, which is more electronegative? Between hydrogen and chlorine, which is more electronegative?
Chlorine.
Chlorine is more electronegative. Very good. And hence, the electron will be pulled towards chlorine. Right? Here also. And hence, if the electrons are pulled towards chlorine, chlorine will gain a delta, a partial negative charge. And when the electrons are lost by hydrogen, it will gain a delta positive charge. Similarly, this will be getting a partial positive, and this will be getting a partial negative charge. Now, due to these positive and negative charge, these are opposite, and hence they will do what? Hence they will interact. Okay, hence they will interact with each other, and this interaction will be attractive or repulsive. Can you tell me? This interaction will be attractive or repulsive? Yes, tell me.
Attractive.
Yeah, very good. This will be attractive. Okay. Now this is what this is, dipole-dipole interaction. This is what dipole-dipole interaction is. Now this interaction is dipole-dipole, okay? Not here, between hydrogen, the same molecule, between the chlorine of one molecule and the hydrogen of other molecule. This is dipole-dipole interaction. And this interaction is what? It is a attractive force, okay? It is an attractive force. Now all of you have understood this? Any doubt here? Rishan, Muhammad Umar, Neda, Umar, Reba?
No.
No, sir.
No doubt, na? And now, write with me. Okay, please. Hum seedha scroll karenge. Please write with me. The force of attraction FOA. Okay, we will be referring force of attraction as what? FOA, arising due to interaction between guys, they just keep coming in the class and I get this stuff. Interaction between what? Interaction between two oppositely charged ends of a polar molecule. Okay. Now, what do I mean by polar molecule? See, whenever you have a positive and a negative, you have a positive, that is a partial positive, and this is a negative. So we say there is a dipole moment here. We say there is a dipole here. Why dipole? Because positive is one pole, negative is another pole. That means there are two poles, and hence it is known as dipole. Similarly, here you will have a dipole. Now, in these dipole, hydrogen is at one end, chlorine is at another end. Here also hydrogen is at one end, the chlorine is at another end. And hence we have here what? Two dipoles. And if anything has a dipole, we say it is polar. Now, since dipole is present in a molecule, we say it is a polar molecule. It is a polar molecule. Everybody done?
Yes.
Yes. Okay. Now, write with me. Okay. So, you guys have learned gravitation, yes or no? Gravitation chapter padha aap logon ne? Achha. Do you know the formula for the force of attraction? For the force, gravitational force?
Gmm by r square.
Yeah, gmm by r square. Okay. So, this is F. Force is equal to what? G. M1, M2 upon R square. Now, you also see that wherever there is a force, you will have some inverse relation with R, right? You will have some inverse relation with R. Now, here it is to the squared. Here you have to the squared. That means if you increase the distance by 2 times, the force of attraction will decrease by 4 times. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes? Okay. Now, this also gives you the idea about the sensitivity of the force. Okay, sensitivity. How much distance sensitive it is, how much distance sensitive it is, because if we are increasing just 2, then it is getting 4 times. Okay, it is decreasing 4 times. Now, you just have to write this, that if you have dipole-dipole force, if you have dipole-dipole force of attraction, then it is 1 upon r to the power 3, 1 upon r to the power. That means it is inversely proportional to the distance, and by the magnitude, that is 3 times. Okay, that is the cubic times, I would say, not only 3 times, rather it is cubic times. That means if I increase the distance by 2 units, I will get a decrease in what? 8 units. I will get a decrease in 8 units. But this is only if you have temperature, it is zero. Temperature zero means the molecules are stationary. For stationary molecule. Acha. Can you, there's one question, please listen to this very carefully and tell me, can temperature be negative?
Yes.
Okay. Nida, Reba?
Yes, sir.
Yes, it can. Achha. Can distance be negative?
No.
No, I'm not talking about displacement, and we are talking about distance, and a distance cannot be. So we measure, we always measure distance only, right? We measure distance. You will measure. Yeah. And what are the other, what are the other things that you can measure?
Current.
Yeah, current. Can current be negative?
No.
No, right? Achha, what is the intensity of light, right? How much luminous it is. Can that be negative? Tell me. Intensity of light cannot be negative. It will be dark at least. If it is very less, it will be dark. Achha. So you see that if you are measuring anything, please listen. If you are measuring anything, it will be always positive. Okay. It will be all because you are measuring. Agar koi cheez rahega tabhi to aap usko measure kar paiyega. Samajh rahe hain? Kuch rahega tabhi to. Acha, agar distance kahin pe nahi hai to aap measure nahi kar paiyega usko. Now, if it is there, then only you can measure it. Right? That means even if the temperature, there is some temperature present. Okay, there is some temperature. Now, it is the limitation of the Celsius scale. It is the limitation of the Celsius scale that we have negative temperatures in Celsius scale. But generally speaking, temperatures can never be negative because you are measuring it. Think how counterintuitive is it? It is that you are measuring something which is not present. Negative ka matlab kya ho? It is not present. Na? If you are measuring something which is zero, if I will say distance is zero, then what we will understand? There is no distance. Yes or no? right? If I will say that lumen intensity of light is zero, then that is the darkness. Yes or no? There is no light, right? There is no light. Now, what is, if I will say current is zero, तब क्या बोलिएगा आप लोग? There is no current. If I say temperature is zero, then there is no temperature, right? There is no, but in degree Celsius, there is some temperature. Because obviously we feel something there, right? There is some temperature. There is some temperature in 0 degrees Celsius also. Now that is a limitation of 0 degrees Celsius. That is why we never use degree Celsius in scientific studies. You will always see Kelvin. Yes or no?
Yes.
Right. So Kelvin is what? A Kelvin. You will also say, sir, minus Kelvin. Minus mein jayega hi nahi. You have 0 Kelvin, which is -273 degrees Celsius. You can never go lower than that, and we will prove that in today's lecture. Okay, we will prove that. No. Sorry. Really, sir. Not today's lecture. Today's. This chapter. Okay. So, एक चीज आप लोगों ने नहीं सीखी साइंस में, you will never have negative temperatures. Okay, you will have never have negative temperature. It doesn't make any sense. Okay, so as a first stationary molecule, that means if you have 0 Kelvin, okay, if you have 0 Kelvin, that point nothing is moving. That point nothing, even the atoms are not moving. But if you have 0 degrees Celsius, there are atoms and everything are moving. Okay, if you have anything, temperature, if it is present, if it is measurable, then things are moving inside the substance. Now for that, the dipole-dipole interaction is R cube. But if you have some temperature present, then dipole-dipole force of attraction is 1/r⁶. Yeah, this is for, you say, rotating molecule. This is what we say for rotating molecule. Okay. Now let us move on to the next one. What is after this? Dipole induced dipole, right?
Yes, sir.
Dipole induced dipole. So please listen again. Dipole induced dipole. Now in dipole induced dipole, let us take, for example, you have two molecules HCl. Now again, I need another molecule. Here I am taking a molecule that is H2, which is HNH. Okay, now there are two molecules. Now I can talk about intermolecular forces of interaction. Okay, what are the intermolecular interactions here? Now for HCl, I can make the electron density. I can say that it is more towards what? It is more towards chlorine, and it is very less towards hydrogen, like this. Can I draw it like this? Yes or no? Tell me. I can draw it like orbital also, na? I can draw it like this. Can I draw it like this? Electron density.
Yes, sir.
Right. So there will be negative here, some negative here, and here, and there will be many negative in this part of the cloud. But for hydrogen, what I will do? Hydrogen, I can only make it like this. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Because both of the hydrogens are what? Both of the hydrogens are same. Please don't say that, sir. Sirf isme do hi electron honge. I'm just talking about the electron density here. Okay. You can see many negative charge. That means it is the whole thing is negatively charged. The whole thing is negatively charged. Now, this is individually talking about HCl and H2. Now, when they interact, when they will be interacting, now then what will happen? Since there are more negative charges in the chlorine end, when I will get this H2 molecule near to HCl, what will happen? These negative charges, these electron density will feel repulsion. Okay, the electron density will repel here, and what they will be doing? They will be forcing these negative charges to move in the opposite direction. Okay, so after interaction, how it will be? So these are the negative charges here. You have many negative charges at this point, and you still have. This is the H2. This was our H2, but it has changed something like this. What has happened? The negative charge which were present here, na? They move this side. Now, tell me about something. This is a colony. There is one person who has. Let us say, 20 million rupees. Okay, but the other community member, they have, let us say, 100 billion. All of them are having 100 billion. Now, if I look at this context, this 20 million one will be poor, right?
Yes.
If I look in this community. Now, similarly, if you have a sea of electron, okay, if you have sea of electron, that means you have sea of negative charges, but there is a point in the sea where there is no negative charge, okay? I'm not saying there's a positive charge there. I'm saying in a sea of electrons, you have a hole. You have nothing present. Then that hole will act as a positive charge, okay? Because see, he is not poor, but in this case, he is poor, right? Similarly, if you have vacant spaces, this will act as what? A positive charge. This will act as a positive charge. Now here also what we have seen, that this was a permanent dipole. This was a permanent dipole. It has induced this dipole. It has induced the polarity here, okay? Now this was permanent. Dipole, and this is what, this is induced dipole. This is induced dipole. Okay, is everyone clear with this?
Yes, sir.
So dipole, induced dipole, please write this. It is r to the power of 6. It is also r to the power of 6. Please write this down. If you have not written, let me know if you're done. Let me know if you're done. Yes, Nida, Rishan, Reba, done?
Yes.
Okay, so just make something like this here. And this is what? Dipole, induced dipole. Umar, are you done?
Yes, sir.
Okay. All right. Please write with me, okay? The intermolecular force, the IMF, intermolecular force arising due to deformity, right, or distortion, deformity or distortion in electrons. Distortion is what? Distortion in electrons, or rather I should say electron cloud, it is a better word, in electron cloud okay, so where is the deformity happening, in the polar molecule or the non-polar? Tell me, where is the deformity happening, in the polar or non-polar?
Non-polar.
Yeah. The distortion of electron cloud of non-polar molecule. Non-polar molecule or atom. Non-polar distortion in electron cloud of non-polar molecule or atom by a permanent dipole. By a permanent dipole. Let me know if you're done. Okay, Reba is done. What about others? Nida is done. Rishan, Umar, and Umar. Muhammad Umar and Umar Abdullah.
Done, sir.
Okay. Next is London forces or dispersion forces. Okay, Rishan. London forces or dispersion forces. London forces or dispersion forces. Now, in this, what we have in this, both of the molecules are non-polar. Okay, both of the non-molecules are non-polar. And this is non-polar. This is also non-polar. So, what will be there? You will be having the electron density distributed equally. What I mean, the electron cloud in and the electrons, these are moving, right? The electrons are always moving, yes or no? They are in constant motion?
Yes, sir.
Right. They are in constant motion. So what I can think is that we can think that sometimes, we can say sometimes what can happen, the electrons, now they are in perfectly symmetrical position. They are not distorted anywhere. But what can happen sometimes, let us say this molecule here, this molecule, some electrons are present here and there is no electron here. So you get a positive charge here, right? You get a positive charge here. And there can be some other instance where you will have no electron here also and no electron here also. So what will happen? Sometimes you will get more electrons. This is one instant. Okay, this is one instant. Please remember, this is one instant. Now, if I will look, for example, if I'm looking at H2 molecule, if I'm looking at H2 molecule, this is the electron density. Okay, this is the electron density. Let us say I'm watching this for 10 minutes. In 10 minutes, there will be some instance in which the electron density will be like this. There will be other instances where the electron density will be like this. Okay. Now, on average, it will be uniform. On average, it will be uniform. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Right. For example, if I take a snapshot and I slow record it, for example, in nanoseconds, then I will be taking 1111 photo, nano, 1 nanosecond. Okay, one frame will be 1 nanosecond. Okay. So what do we say? 16 frame per second. One frame per nanosecond. Yeah. One frame per nanosecond. Then I will be obviously seeing some distortion here and there, right? In instances. Okay. In instance. So whatever interaction or whatever dipole it is made here, it is known as instantaneous dipole. This is known as instantaneous dipole. Instantaneous dipole. Okay, this is known as what? Instantaneous dipole. Here the dipole is how? Here the dipole is like this. Positive side and the negative side is here. Now this dipole which is formed here, it will induce the dipole here also. So you will get some dipole here. Right? And, you have positive charge, so negative charge will be coming this side. And you will be some positive charge here. And this will be the dipole moment. This will be the dipole moment. There will be interactions here. And those interactions will be called London forces. Okay. So what I can say, London forces is directly proportional to the electron deformity, okay, electron distortion. If the electron are much distorted or if it is very much in deformity, what will happen? You will have higher London forces, okay? Now, the factors which affect London force, please write. Factors affecting London force. Factors affecting London forces. Please write this down. Let me know if you're done. Atif, we almost ended at this point, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Rishan, Muhammad Umar, Nida, Umar, and Reba. Let me know if you're done.
Done, sir.
Okay, waiting for others. Nida, are you done?
Yes.
Okay. Okay, Rishan, okay. One second. Umar, you're writing?
I'm done.
Okay, you're done. Okay, you have to speak then, now you're done. Just waiting for you, Rishan, now. Okay, you're done, I think. Yeah. Okay, Umar, I got it. So factors affecting what? Factors affecting electron dust. What we will be seeing here is not factors affecting the London forces directly. Rather, what we will be looking at, we can see the electron distortion, where it will be high and where it can be low. So for example, if I talk about the size. So if I will say size increases, if the size will increase, what do you think? The distortion, the chances of distortion chances of deformity, it will be high or low? Tell me.
High.
High, right? So if size increases, then what will happen? Electron distortion will be high. And if the electron distortion is high, then what I can say, London force. And London force is an example of van der Waals force. And I will say increase in, there will be increase in van der Waals forces. Right? Second point is that. Now, if you will have number of electrons. So hash sign is for number of electron. If the number of electron increases, then also we can say electron distortion will be high. Right? And hence you will also increase in van der Waals forces. Increase in van der Waals forces. Now, third is the molecular structure. Molecular structure. Now, while we are looking at molecular structure, let us do that. Do and look at an example. If you have CH3, CH2, CH2, and you have CH2. Okay, CH3. This is known as butane. There are four carbons. You can also have butane like this. You have carbon and you have all the CH3s at one carbon. CH3. Not butane, but you can have the same carbon number and same hydrogens. And there will be a hydrogen here. Okay. Now, look at the shape. I mean, look at the size here. Right? Look at the size here. And then look at the size here. Tell me which will be large.
Butane.
Yeah, butane, right? And अच्छा आप लोगों ने नेमिंग अभी नहीं सीखा होगा ना. नेमिंग का आप लोगों ने नहीं सीखा होगा. हमसे तो नहीं सीखा है लेकिन क्लास में सीख लिया होगा. दिस इज ब्यूटीन. राइट. एंड व्हाट इज दिस? 1, 2, 3 प्रोप. एंड दिस इज व्हाट? 2-methylpropene. दिस इज 2-methyl प्रोपीन. बट इफ आई लुक एट द फॉर्मूला, दिस इज ऑल्सो वॉट? दिस इज C4 एंड H10. What about this? This is also C4. And how many hydrogens are there? There are 10 hydrogens you can count. So even though what is there, even though the number of carbons and hydrogens are same, but the branching here is what? The branching here is determining what will be the size. And if you look at the size, then what we can say? We can say that if the branching is increasing, then the size is decreasing. And if the size is decreasing, electron distortion is decreasing. And hence what is happening? And hence you will be getting a decrease in van der Waals forces. So what happens when branching increases? When branching increases, what you will get? You will get a decrease in size. If size decreases, the electron distortion decreases. If electron distortion decreases, then there is a decrease in van der Waals forces. Write this down. Let me know if you are done.
Sir,
everyone done?
So can you show two factors affecting?
Yeah, sure.
Okay, sir, done.
Okay. Now you will write hydrogen bonding. The last point, just hydrogen bonding. Atif, you have to write from here, okay?
Okay.
Hydrogen bonding. Okay. So hydrogen bonding is not, I mean, it is same as dipole-dipole interaction, but it is only a special type of dipole-dipole interaction. Okay. It is a special type of dipole-dipole interaction. Please write with me. Dipole-dipole dipole-dipole interaction. In molecules which have hydrogen bonded to fluorine, oxygen or nitrogen. Okay, fluorine or nitrogen or oxygen. Dipole-dipole dipole-dipole interaction, dipole-dipole interaction in molecules which have hydrogen bonded to fluorine, oxygen or nitrogen is very high and hence given a category of itself. Okay, and this category is what? This is hydrogen bonding. Okay, so for example, if you have HF molecule, so all this will be having delta positive, this will be delta negative, delta positive, delta negative, delta positive, delta negative. Okay, so fluorine is what? Fluorine is the most electronegative element, so most of the electrons will be present here only, right? It will be very near to a true positive charge, and there will be some interactions. So this interaction between the fluorine and hydrogen, action between this fluorine and hydrogen, these are intermolecular hydrogen bonding. These are what? Intermolecular hydrogen bonding. These are hydrogen bonding. Similarly, if you have water, okay, so if you have water is like this, HOH, you have seen that its shape will be what? Bent. Its shape will be bent. Then you can have hydrogen here. We'll have, let us say, oxygen, hydrogen, right? And again, you can have, can I put an oxygen here or here? Where should I put? Let us see here only. Between these two, right? So these are what? These are hydrogen bonding, okay? Similarly, you can also have with nitrogen, NH3. Okay. Let me know if you're done. Reba is done. Let me know if you're done, Atif.
Sir, done.
Done, okay. Nida, Umar. Atif, are you done?
Yes, sir.
Okay. You can also have, see, it is not only construct, I mean, it is not limited to HF, H2O, and NH3. If you have these fragments, na, OH, NH2, then also you can have hydrogen bonding. Okay, so what I will write. See, for fluorine, it will be only if you have HF. But if you have OH, so oxygen can make two bonds. So oxygen has one bond with hydrogen and the other bond will be with something else. Okay, it will be with something else. Similarly, nitrogen can bond three bonds. So nitrogen can have one bond with something else. The other bonds can be with hydrogen and hydrogen. Nitrogen can also show hydrogen bonding if it has something like this. Nitrogen. And here it is making some bond with some other element, and here it has nitrogen. For example, here you will have, let us say, CH3OH. Okay, CH3OH. Okay, CH3OH. And there will be another CH3OH somewhere. Actually, see, even the CH3OH will be bent. You'll have hydrogen here. You'll have oxygen here, and you will have CH3 here. Okay. Then you will have, let us say, hydrogen, oxygen, and CH3 here. Then there can be interaction like this. Okay. So let me just get this and. Okay, you can write this for OH. For example, for NH, you can have R. R means any alkyl group. Then you can have nitrogen, and hydrogen one, and one hydrogen here. we can also have, let us say, nitrogen here. Okay, so this can interact like this, this can interact like this. These are what? These are hydrogen bonds. So please write this down. I will show you in the PC. Let me know if you're done. Are you guys done? Neva is done. Atif, Muhammad, Umar, Nida.
Done, sir.
Done. Atif, you're done?
Yes.
Acha. Can you see this? Can you guys see this?
Yes,
tell me. Yes. Okay. So I will be starting with H2O. Okay. HF, I think all of you will understand in HF. This is very straightforward. So this is one water molecule. Now, can I explain intermolecular forces using one water molecule? Tell me.
No, sir.
No.
Okay. Then I have to add another water molecule. I will add here. Okay. I will add here. Then I will add some other here. Then I will add here. Let us add here. So I'm not adding them very closely. Okay. Now you will see the effect of intermolecular force. So it has some property inside it which makes it polar. Now when it is making it polar, it has positive and negative ends. It has positive and negative ends. I hope I can show you guys polarity also. Or the whole polarity is given here. It is Avogadro. It is Avogadro. Okay. I don't want the dipole now. Now I will optimize it. Okay. So this arrangement of H2O, no, it is not in the least energy state. Okay. It is not the most stable state it can get. So if I will give it some free space, now it can move around and it can stabilize itself. Okay. Now please, you will see how they are stabilizing itself. They will start moving. Okay. Can you see that moving? Now can you see that?
Yes, sir.
How they have stuck together? See? Right, so they are just catching each other then, and they are still, they are getting the most optimized structure. See, they are forming more number of hydrogen bondings. I mean, the maximum number of hydrogen bonding they can form, they have formed the maximum number of hydrogen bonding. Right, so the yellow lines that you are seeing, now, those are what? Hydrogen bondings. All of you got this, yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Right, now,
yes, sir.
Next here, okay, so see, no, I will be doing for nitrogen. When I will put nitrogen here, this software is something like that. It will adjust the valencies. Nitrogen can make three bonds, then it will always adjust the valency with hydrogens. Can you see this mark here, adjust hydrogens?
Yes.
Can you see it? Okay, so whenever I'm making, then it will complete the valency with hydrogen. So I'm keeping the NH3s here, and then I will put NH3 here. Then I will see how they will behave if I will give them free space. So they're moving a bit slowly because oxygen is more electronegative, so it had the dipole moment was high there, but still they are moving now. Yeah, they can reach, they have reached here. Now they will be attracting those two, right? Yeah, these two are also moving, but I don't think they will be able to come here. So I have got this structure. So this is known as simulation. Okay, what I am doing, I am simulating what should be happening in reality. You will see that this energy, now this will be getting down. I mean, it will be lowered. It is in negative 60.82. It will get to 3. And this is the change in energy in each step. Okay, fine. This much is fine. You cannot see hydrogen bonding in this. Okay. Yeah, I cannot see any hydrogen bonding here. But let us see if I add here to see if I add some molecule, then I can see. Let us optimize the structure. Yeah, now I'm getting some hydrogen bonding here, okay? So you have to try optimizing. And you can see that initially it was 60, now it is getting to 90. So when you are adding hydrogen bonding, what is happening? You are making the molecule stable, right? You can make the molecule stable. Now let me erase this and let me give you some examples if you have some organic molecules, okay? So we have, let us take carbon. I will have carbon and this will give me hydrogens. I will change one hydrogen to what? One hydrogen to oxygen. So as soon as I will do this, what will happen? This valency will be again satisfied like this. You see OH, and can you see that it is again bent? Can you see the structure? It is bent for OH. Yes or no? अभी नहीं दिख रहा होगा, देखिए, it is bent, right? नहीं दिख रहा क्या आप लोगों को?
Yes sir.
हाँ, okay. ऐसे तो आप लोग शांत हो जाते हैं, कुछ दिख ही नहीं रहा. Then again, I will have another. This is, yeah, and then I will need an oxygen. And similarly, we will do a few more carbon. Again, just add one more carbon and hydrogens, no oxygens. One oxygen here, let us give one oxygen here, okay? And then let us optimize and see whether we can find some hydrogen bondings here. So these guys are moving. Yeah, obviously, I have found another hydrogen bonding, and there's one more. There can be one more if I optimize it. I will give them a good starting point. But you can see that this is an organic molecule. So not only in water, but if you have OH bond, which is present, no? Then you can have the hydrogen bonding. And I think similar will be the case if I will change the oxygen to nitrogen. So let me just change the oxygen to nitrogen. And again, you can see, let me optimize the structure. I don't know, for some reasons in nitrogen, it is not showing initially any hydrogen bonding. I think I should not waste time here. And let me draw quickly a carbon. Then I will have to draw a nitrogen here. Then let me optimize and see whether I can, no. Yeah, there is some hydrogen bonding. There is some hydrogen bonding. So, I mean, from these studies, you can already predict that the hydrogen bonding, it is, the OH hydrogen bonding is more strong. Yes or no? Right, guys? The OH can form more strong hydrogen bonding. You can see that it has higher ability to form hydrogen bonding than the NH3 molecules, the nitrogen molecules. Okay, let me just stop this and let us go back to our screen here. Yeah. So here we saw that we have different types of hydrogen bonding, and then we will describe the rank for intermolecular forces of attraction, okay, order of. Intermolecular forces of attraction. Intermolecular forces of attraction. See, hydrogen bonding will be the highest because it is hydrogen bonding. Hydrogen bonding is the highest. Second, you have dipole-dipole interaction. Dipole-dipole. Third is dipole induced dipole. And the fourth one is London forces. London forces is present in nonpolar molecule. This is a mix, and we will usually not come across these examples where you are comparing the intermolecular forces of attraction for mixed substances, okay? Now, dipole-dipole interaction is for polar molecule. And here you have what? Here you have a hydrogen bond with fluorine, oxygen, or nitrogen. You just remember fluorine, oxygen, or nitrogen. If you have hydrogen attached to fluorine, oxygen, or nitrogen, then you will be having hydrogen bonding. And this is the highest, okay? This is the largest force of attraction, hydrogen bonding between any two molecules. Done, guys?
Yes.
Okay. All of you are done. Atif, Muhammad Umar, Umar Abdullah, Rishan.
Yes, sir.
Yes, Atif, you are done?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, when we started with this chapter, now we said that what? We said that intermolecular forces of attraction will determine whether something is solid, liquid, or gas. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Can you think of any other factor which determine whether something is solid, liquid, or gas?
Melting or boiling.
So, indirectly, you are seeing temperature. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, temperature. Achha. You have just boiled the water, okay? You have just boiled the water, okay? And at 0 degrees Celsius, the water freezes, yes or no? At 0 degrees Celsius?
Yes, sir.
Right? Now, there is a fridge. There is a fridge. And this here has, let us say, 0 degrees Celsius, okay? At 0 degrees Celsius. And then you got this container and you put the container in this fridge. Now, what do you think? Will it instantly freeze? Will it instantly? No, it will not instantly freeze. Why? The temperature is 0 degrees Celsius now. Then it should freeze.
Takes time to.
It will take time. Time to what?
Fight against the force.
Time to? It will take time to do what?
Change the state.
Okay, some parts of what you are answering now. Yeah, Atif, you want to say something?
No, sir, I'm not sure.
You're not sure. What about Muhammad Umar? You want to say something? Why it does not freeze instantly?
I have no idea.
Also, that means, the way we say things, no, it is not very correct. Because we say that at 0 degrees Celsius, water should freeze. So we have also to add time. Na? You are saying time bhi lagega. Then you have to always add what? 0 degrees Celsius. Then give the water this much time at 0 degrees Celsius and then it will freeze. Right? But what is this 0 degrees Celsius? Okay, what is this 0 degrees Celsius? There are two things. Whenever you are talking, there are two things. What we call a system. In chemistry, we call the system. And system is the thing that we are observing. Okay, system is the thing that we are observing. At this point, what is our system? What is our system? The water in this container, right? Yes or no? You're observing this. And there is the part around it which is affecting the system, which is known as surrounding. Right? So surrounding, please remember that surrounding is something which will be affecting the system. Okay. Now, surrounding and system, if I will enclose these two, then you will get a universe. This is the universe. Okay. This is the universe. For hours, agar aapne paani boil kiya aur usko fridge mein rakh diya, right? You have boiled the water and you have kept it in fridge. Then for that boiled water, what is its universe? Inside the fridge only, right? Now, anything other than that, it is not affecting. It is not affecting the system. You will learn about system, surrounding, then the part which is differentiating between the system and the surrounding is known as boundary. Okay. So the container is boundary here. Right? Container is the boundary. Yes. So there are two things. Tak yahi pe baat aati hai, that you will have a temperature for surrounding and you will have a temperature for system. Yes or no? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Right? So when we are talking about 0 degrees Celsius, now we are talking that when the temperature of water is 0 degrees Celsius, not the surrounding, not of container also, not of container, not of the environment that you are putting it in. We are talking about if you have 0 degrees Celsius, the temperature of water should be 0 degrees Celsius, not the surrounding. You got the difference? There is a nuance here. All of you?
Yes.
Now, will you be able to answer this question if somebody asks you and somebody wants to trick you in some confusion? You can answer it, right? You have got the terms, system, surrounding, boundary, correct? So please use these terms and then you will be able to answer this question that why even if it is surrounding a 0 degrees, whenever we say 0 degrees Celsius, the melting point or the boiling point, it is of that particular system that we are talking about. For water, it is 0 degrees Celsius. That is the freezing point or melting point. Okay, freezing point or melting point. Okay. That means we have to also consider one more factor, which is the temperature. Okay, which is the temperature and what we say as the thermal energy. So please write next topic, which is thermal energy. So we always talk about the thermal energy because temperature, it is always going to confuse people. It is always going to confuse people whether we are talking about surrounding or the system. Now thermal energy, what it is? The energy, please write with me, the energy. Of a body, the energy of a body due to motion of its atom or molecule. Okay, this is thermal energy. Now, if you have a gases, you can have liquid, you can have solid, right? You can have solid. Now, if I move from gas to liquid, sorry, if I move from gas to solid, then I can see that the intermolecular forces are increasing, right? The intermolecular forces are increasing. IMF increases this way. And if I'm talking about going from solid to gas in this direction, then what is increasing here? The thermal energy of the systems of the system is increasing. Okay, so thermal energy of the system is increasing. Right, thermal energy of the system is increasing. That is why we also classify what if the atoms can easily move. Now, if the atoms can easily move, then those things are known as fluids. Okay, those things are known as fluids. That is gas and liquid, both are fluids. Okay, not only liquid. In general language, we say fluids are liquids, but fluids are essentially everything that can flow and that constitutes also gases. Please let me know if you're done.
Done, sir.
Done? Okay. Now, from this comes the point of melting point and boiling point, right? Melting point and boiling point. So let us first talk about the boiling point. As of now, I will not be defining boiling point. I mean, I'm pretty sure the definition that you will have for boiling point, it is not very scientific. Tell me now if somebody can define boiling point. हाँ अच्छा हमने कह दिया था अब तो किसी को हिम्मत भी नहीं हो रही बोलने की या आई कैन हियर सम वॉइस हु वाज दैट
सो द पॉइंट वेयर समथिंग स्टार्ट्स बॉइलिंग
रियली रियली यू विल आंसर इट लाइक दिस द पॉइंट दैट
द टेंपरेचर रिक्वायर्ड फॉर अ सब्सटेंस टू कन्वर्ट फ्रॉम लिक्विड टू गैस
अच्छा नाउ शुड आई कंफ्यूज यू
Yes,
okay. So you throw some water, okay, in the floor. It will also get converted into vapor. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Tab bataiye, boil ho raha hai kya? Is that boiling? Tell me, is it boiling then? No, yes, na? Hai na? Think about it. Hai na? Sochne wali baat. Think about it. Slowly, slowly. है ना, राज धीरे धीरे खुलेंगे. साइंस है ना, व्हाट इज साइंस? साइंस इज अबाउट एक्सप्लेनेशन एंड समटाइम्स प्रेडिक्शन. आई विल से जनरली एक्सप्लेनेशंस ऑफ व्हाट एवर यू सी, व्हाट एवर इज हैपनिंग हियर. ओके, अच्छा, रीबा ऑल्सो वॉन्टेड टू से समथिंग. रीबा, यस रीबा.
Nothing, sir.
Nothing, you don't want to say now. Acha, fine. Acha, does anyone have any other boiling point definition? No. Okay, fine. So boiling point. Okay. So what I can say is boiling point is directly. I can say this much, na? If I will have a high intermolecular force of attraction, if the attraction is higher, then it will require more temperature to boil. That means I can say the boiling point is directly proportional to, the boiling point is directly proportional to what? Intermolecular force of attraction. Yes or no?
Yes.
Right? Okay. Now you have the rank of intermolecular forces of attraction, hydrogen bonding, then dipole, dipole, then London forces. Yes? You have the rank?
Yes, sir.
Right. Okay. So we'll get a question. Compare the boiling point of following. Okay, of following. You have CH3OH. B, you have CH3. You have CH3Cl. And C, you have CH3 and there is H. That means what is this? This is CH4. Can you give the answer in chat? Please use greater than or less than sign. Don't use comma here because I have not asked you to write in ascending or descending order. Then guys, send the answer in chat. Can you identify polar molecule, hydrogen bonded molecule and non-polar molecule? All of you, can you identify that? First tell me. No? Or yes? Are? Yes, Muhammad Umar, can you identify? D to hai hi nahi. मोहम्मद उमर, डी कहाँ है? I have written this is equivalent to.
Sir, I think we can identify by seeing like the electronegativity of the element.
Yeah, exactly, correct. Electronegativity, I mean, for hydrogen bonding, you have to look at fragments. What fragment? NH or OH fragments. Okay, then obviously there will be hydrogen bonding there, and then you have polarity. For polarity, you need what? Electronegativity. So here you have OH, right? So that is why here there will be hydrogen bonding. And then here you will be having what? Dipole-dipole interaction. Here you will be having, this is non-polar, then only London forces. Right, only London forces. This is what this is. This is polar. So obviously if I will rank them first of all in the intermolecular forces of attraction, then hydrogen bonding will be the highest, then the polar, and then you will have London, that is in non-polar. Now we know that boiling point and intermolecular forces, they are directly proportional. That is why the same order will be consistent. So we'll be having CH3OH will have the highest boiling point, and you will have CH3Cl and CC, and C will be CH4. Okay, so the correct order is A, B, and then C. Please write this down. Let me know if you're done.
Then, sir.
Okay. Now comes melting point. Melting point. Okay. Now, for melting point, there are two things. Okay. There are two things in melting point. First is, melting point depends on two factors. The first is what? Obviously, intermolecular forces of attraction. Intermolecular force of attraction. And secondly, it also depends. Secondly, it also depends on the packing of what atoms or molecule, packing of particles, whatever is making a solid. Because whenever you are melting from solid to liquid. Now in solid, see, you will have something like this. Okay, so these are what? These are carbon chain. These are carbon chain like this. Okay, so they can stack very easily. But if you have something like this, let us say. Now, it cannot stack very comfortably. Like, I mean, the most symmetrical structure will be like this. So there are some gaps here. There are already some gaps here. Then what happens? Now, the packing also defines what will be the boiling point. Sorry, what will be the melting point? So if the packing is very stacked, okay, it is very symmetrical, then you can boil it you can melt it very easily. But if it is not stacking and if it is having some weird type of structure, like if, for example, for this, if we have, then what will be the packing? How do you think there will be packing? You will have packing like this. Okay. You can have some other, it will be packed like this. So this is not a very effective pack. But if you see this type of molecule here, it has very effective packing. Achha, you have heard about saturated and unsaturated? You know saturated, sir. Unsaturated? Yes. What about others? Muhammad Umar, Nida?
Yes, sir.
Saturated means what?
Sir, only single bonds between the molecules.
Arre bhai. Saturated means if there is enough of something. For example, generally speaking, saturation means what? Saturation point. You are adding, let us say, for example, sugar in water. So there is a capacity, there is a limit to which you can dissolve the sugar in water. Right, Arthur? And after a point, you cannot dissolve furthermore. The sugar will be like that only. It will be not dissolving. Correct?
Yes, sir.
Right. So that is the saturation point. That means you cannot dissolve more sugar. Anna? Now, when you are reading, and you are taking classes, and you are, 6 hours, 8 hours of classes, then you will be like, oh, dimag saturate ho gaya. What is now? Your brain has got saturated. It cannot retain any more information. It cannot get any more information. Okay. So that is what saturation is. Now, in terms of chemistry, we say saturated hydrocarbons and unsaturated hydrocarbons. Okay. Saturated hydrocarbons and unsaturated hydrocarbons. Now, when you have what is saturated here, then what is saturated and what is unsaturated? I mean, what is something that we cannot add furthermore? Let us see by this example. If you have carbon and carbon, and then you have 3 hydrogens here, okay? You have 3 hydrogens. Now, for 2 carbon, the maximum hydrogen that you can add is how much? 6. But if you have a double bond here, then you have hydrogen and hydrogen. Yes? So tell me, in the A structure here, can you add any more hydrogens? Yes or no?
No, sir, we cannot add more hydrogen.
Right? All of you, Nida, Umar, all of them, we cannot add more hydrogen. But what about in B? What about in B? If I break this double bond, then we can add more hydrogens. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Right? That is why A is known as saturated. That means we have saturated the number of hydrogens we can add. And B, where you have double bond, we say it is unsaturated. Okay. So you have, identification and definition. Atif, this is for you because you answered it. That was a correct answer. But identification of something and definition of something is very different. Okay. So okay, you will identify saturated by seeing the single bond. But that is not the definition. Got it? You are identifying saturated as something which has single bonds only. But that is not the definition. What is the definition? Definition is that it is saturated hydrocarbon because we cannot add more hydrogens to it. Okay. Fine. So if you have some book now which is saying saturated hydrocarbons are those in which there is only single bond, they are talking about the identification. They are not talking about the definition there. Okay. That is why you will, now this is your homework. Google about saturated fatty acid and unsaturated fatty acid. Okay. And then you will get some idea, and then you will tell me which one is which is healthy and which is not healthy. Okay. Can you do this? Simple assignment.
So unsaturated is healthy and saturated is not healthy.
Why saturated is not healthy and unsaturated is healthy?
That I'm not sure about.
You will Google and tell me. Okay. And it is about packing. You will see it is about packing, all of you. Okay. I'm just giving you a hint. It is about packing. Right. Now, the melting point obviously also depends on intermolecular forces of attraction and packing. So we have learned that how intermolecular forces of attraction will act, melting point is directly proportional to what? IMF, OA of attraction. And melting point is directly proportional to symmetrical packing. Done, all of you? Done. Tell me. Now I can move on to gaseous state.
Yeah.
The main chapter, right? So the main chapter. See, the part that we have learned here, now, they are very, this part I will be always referring when I will be teaching organic chemistry in next year, 12th standard. All these melting point, boiling point, intermolecular forces of attraction, these will be very helpful when you are studying 12th standard. Okay. Somewhere in 11th standard is also going to come, obviously, but it is more helpful in organic chemistry of 12th standard. See, that is why I say, everything is important. In chemistry, there are some chapters which are standalone. For example, metallurgy. Metallurgy is standalone. Okay, it is standalone. Now, obviously, if you have some information about periodic table and you have some idea about reactivity metallurgy, it will help you. But it is a standalone chapter. It is not going to benefit any other chapters. But these chapters, some parts here and there, they are all important. Okay. Now, gaseous state. Also, please keep your notes in a very proper way. In a very proper way. Okay. Gaseous state. No. We are going to understand the gaseous state. So we have a container here. We are going to put some gaseous molecule here. Now, there are a few things that we can measure about this gas. Okay, this is the bulk property. Okay, we're going to understand the bulk properties. So in the bulk property, I can measure the pressure. Yes or no? We can measure the pressure. Tell me. Are we have some devices now from which we can measure the pressure. No,
yeah.
You have not heard. You guys have cylinder in your houses. Tell me. You guys have gas cylinder? Huh? No.
Yes.
So you have never seen some people measuring the pressure in the gas? Have you not even heard of that? In the gas cylinder? No. Reba? No, never. Achha, yes. So boli na bhai. Then please speak. Pressure. Okay, what is used for measuring pressure? We have two devices. Okay, we have two devices. There is barometer. Barometer, you must have heard about barometer. But barometer is only used for measuring of atomic pressure. Usually, we use manometer. Okay. For some container and all, what is the pressure? We use manometer. And we can also measure the temperature. You can also measure the temperature. And obviously, if I will measure, we can also measure the volume. Now, if I will be knowing the volume, I can also tell you about the number of moles. Yes or no? I can also talk about number of moles. Yeah. number of moles. Now pressure is given by capital P, temperature is given by capital T, volume is given by capital V, and you have for number of moles small letter n. Please remember, whenever you see a T which is small, na, this is time, this capital T is temperature. Let me know if you're done writing this part. Done. Also, for pressure, temperature, volume, and number of moles, you must be knowing about temperature. That is, it has units Kelvin, it has units of degree Celsius, it has units of what? It has units of Fahrenheit. For volume, obviously, you can measure in liters, meter cube, centimeter cube, etc. Number of moles, it has only one unit, that is mole. But for pressure, you must be knowing some units. For example, acha, tell me na pressure of units of pressure. Units of pressure.
Sir, Pascal, atmospheric pressure.
Yeah, Pascal, atmospheric pressure. Bar. Then you have bar, torr. Yeah, bar is also there. Yes, right. Very good.
So okay. There is something called mercury, right?
Mercury. Mm of mercury or centimeter of mercury. Okay. So these are also there. So whenever, if you want to measure pressure, you want to talk about temperature, you want to talk about volume, number of moles, etc. Then what we have to do? You have to also study the units. You have to know what units are there. Okay. Aap log, aapko ek scale de diya, usme unit hi nahi hai. Okay. You have got a scale. It is just a stick then. Na? It is just a stick. Can you see how things change? How fast things can change? If you have, what is this? This is a stick now. Right now it is a stick. But how the usability increases? If you just add some lines here, there's a vast increase in the usability of this thing, correct? Now this has become what? This has become scale. This has become scale now, right? So obviously we need some units. Can I move on?
Yes, sir.
So we will be discussing just the unit of pressure because you are already familiar with the units of temperature, volume, and number of moles. So units of pressure. And pressure you have learned in physics class. What is pressure? Force per unit area, right? Force per unit area. Its SI unit is, it is what? Pascal. This is written as PA. It is equal to 1 Newton per meter square. Equal to 1 Newton per meter square, or you can also write it as Newton per meter square. Now, the thing that we use most generally is what? ATMs and bar. We use ATM and bar. Okay. So we have one ATM. It is equal to 1.01325 into 10 to the power 5 Pascal. And what do? We take approximately this as 1. So this would be 10 to the power 5 Pascal. Okay, 10 to the power 5 Pascal. Also write one more point. 1 bar. It is equal to 1 into 10 to the power 5 Pascal exactly. Okay. And there is a relationship between one ATM and one bar. One ATM it is equal to. So which is greater? Yeah, ATM is greater now. One ATM. It will be equal to how much? 1.01325 bar, and one bar will be equal to 0.987 ATM. Now there are relationships between ATMs. For ATMs, one ATM is also equal to 76 centimeters of HG. And it is also equal to 760 mm of HG. One ATM is also equal to 760 torr. So write these units. And what how many of you use sticky notes or something? And you have a table where you study, you have a specific space where you study. Umar, you have used, yeah. So please write all these units and maybe stick it in a wall where you can see whenever you are studying. Okay. Whenever you are studying, you can see that. Why? Because wherever you are solving some problems, na, then what I will do, I will ask you to refer to these units and then do the conversion. I will not be converting. Okay. I will not be converting Q because I have already converted in my 11th standard. So I will not be converting. It is you who have to convert. And while converting, you will be memorizing these units. Okay. Don't worry about that. ऐसे लेके मत बैठ जाइएगा कि रट रहे हैं बिल्कुल 1 ATM is equal to 1.01325 into 10 to the power 5 Pascal. 1 ATM is equal to 0.1 bar is equal to 0.987 ATM. Don't do, है ना? यही करना रहता, हिलिल के आपको याद करना रहता, मदरसे चले जाते, हिलिल के याद करते रहते, हिलिल के याद करते रहते. Let me know if you are done, guys. All of you are done. Please make the sticky notes, okay? Please make the sticky notes. Next, we will write. So there are some, there are pressure, temperature, volume, and number of moles. And these are the properties of gas, or these are the parameters, I mean, which affect how the gas is behaving, right? Now, we will learn about gas laws. We will learn about gas laws. Achha, how many of you have maths here? Can you please raise hand? I think most of you have maths, but Abhinav and all, they don't have maths. Okay, Muhammad. Nida also, you also have maths, na Nida? No.
No.
You don't have maths? Achha. Achha, only Muhammad Umar. Atif, you have both, na maths also. Huh? Okay, Atif has both. उमर अब्दुल्ला को तो डॉक्टर बनना ही, उनके पास मैथ्स नहीं है. ओके, गैस लॉस, दैट इज वेरी ट्रू मोहम्मद उमर, दैट इज वेरी ट्रू. मैथ्स वन ऑफ द मोस्ट ब्यूटीफुल सब्जेक्ट, गैस लॉस. नाउ व्हाट आर गैस लॉस? व्हेनेवर यू हैव अ लॉ, लॉ विल be used to predict something, okay? It will be used to predict a behavior of gas here now. Law will always predict something. Like, for example, you have Newton's laws of motion, right? Why laws of motion? Because if I will give you the instant, not instant, if I will give you the initial condition, you can tell me about the final condition. Is that right? Yes or no? In Newton's yes. laws of motion, yes. Right? So here also it is similar. I mean, wherever you have law, from initial, you have to predict till the final thing, what is going to happen. So gas law. Gas law is the laws which explain and predict the behavior and their dependence, behavior of gas and its dependence on pressure, volume, temperature, and number of moles. And in laws, we will first of all write the Boyle's law. And they will give me relationship between pressure and volume relation. All of you, please look. Okay. And let us also put a this is a piston. And this is a handle. Okay, this is a handle. What I can do, I can move this piston. Okay, I can move this piston. Can you see this? I can move this piston. Yes or no? Right, we can move this piston. Now. Okay. Here we have some gases. One, okay, I should have some different color. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. One, two, three, four, five. Okay, no, not here. Let me just change the. Okay, here you have same amount of gas. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Okay, so both of them has 10 molecules of gases. Okay, the molecules of gas is what? 10. Now, I can say what will be the pressure here? P1, the volume here is V1, right? Now, the pressure here is P2 and the volume here is V2. So, tell me, where will be the pressure higher?
The P2, V2.
P2, V2? The pressure will be higher here, na? P2. Okay. Pressure is higher? Yeah, the volume is low. And here the pressure is low, the volume is high. Correct? Yes, guys? Is the relationship? So we can see that. We can see that pressure and volume are what? Inversely proportional, right? So we can write, it states that, this law states that for a fixed amount of gas, at constant temperature, now temperature of gas or temperature of the surrounding? This temperature is what? Temperature of surrounding or gas? Boliye, boliye, boliye. Whenever we are talking about na, for a fixed amount of gas at constant temperature, it means the temperature of gas only. Okay, it means temperature of gas.
Sir, okay? Could you repeat?
What? Question?
No, the temperature of gas, what you said previously.
I said that this is the temperature of gas, not the temperature of surrounding.
Okay.
I got it. Anna, yes, so for a fixed amount of gas at constant temperature, the pressure is inversely proportional to the volume. It is inversely proportional to the volume. Okay. You can say P is inversely proportional to volume. Now, I can also say P is what? P is equal to, we can write a constant here. We can write a constant and 1 by V. And hence what we can say? We can say pressure is what? Pressure into volume will be equal to a constant. Okay, so pressure is inversely proportional to what? It is inversely proportional to volume for a fixed amount of gas. Okay, and here is what? Pressure is equal to constant upon volume. Here also pressure and volume are what? Constant. And this equation will be very true if you have the fixed amount of gas. For example, here what is there? Here we can say that P1 V1 is equal to a constant K, and also P2 V2 is also equal to a constant K. Hence, P1 V1 is equal to P2 V2. P1 V1 is equal to P2 V2. Write this down, let me know if you're done. All of you are done. Okay. Also, we can also derive one more relationship. Okay, pressure and density. We all know that density is what? Density is equal to mass divided by volume. And as we know, if the amount is fixed, that means the mass will be also fixed. That means we can say density is inversely proportional to volume. Correct? And we have just seen that. We have just seen, and also pressure is also what? Inversely proportional to volume. Pressure is also inversely proportional to volume. Hence, we cannot say, therefore, pressure is what? Pressure, or we can also say density. Density is directly proportional to density of gas, is directly proportional to pressure. And if it is directly proportional to pressure, then we can say density is also equal to what? K and pressure. And if D upon P is equal to constant, that means D1 P1 is equal to D2 P2. Let me know if you're done. Done, all of you? Yes or no? Yes, guys, done. What about Mohammed Umar, Atif?
Yes, sir, done.
Rishan, done?
Done.
Okay, fine. So, thank you very much. Okay, so we will meet on Monday. This is it for today. We will meet on Monday. Boliye.
Sir, could you accord me to explain me topics that I couldn't comprehend in today's class?
Today's class, tell me which topic.
The first one is what is a dipole?
Dipole, acha. What is a If you want just the in what is dipole, like whenever you have a positive and a negative charge which is separated by a distance d, we say this is dipole. Now, obviously, this was not what you needed, right? So let me ask you a question. Have you heard this word of pole? You must have heard this word pole, right?
Yes, pole, yes.
Yeah, what do you think? What does it mean?
North pole, south pole.
North pole, south pole, right? And you must have also heard this word, which is known as polar opposite. They are, those two persons are polar opposite. Have you heard this?
Yeah, two different, I mean.
Yeah, exactly different, right? So what are these two then? Positive and this is negative. These are also poles.
They're different.
You can say that, right? And how many poles are there? How many poles are there? If I look at this system, how many poles?
Two
poles. That is why this will be dipole. Got it?
Yes, sir.
Anything else?
Yeah. The other question is, what are polar and non-polar molecules?
Okay, non-polar and polar molecule. So, substance or molecule which has dipole is known as what? Polar. It will be what? This molecule will be polar. And if it does not have dipole, if there is no dipole in a molecule, it will be non-polar.
Okay.
And anything else?
Dipole moment is same as dipole, or is there some difference?
Dipole moment is just the when I say it, there is polar and non-polar. No? This is qualitative assessment of a thing. That means you are seeing whether it is present or not present. Dipole moment is when you quantify it, when you give a number to it. That is dipole moment. Okay.
Okay.
We will be, this is problem is arising because we have not completed the chapter 4, that is chemical bonding. In chemical bonding, there is a dipole moment and polarity, and there is polar bonds we have covered. I hope you remember polar bonds, but polar covalent, non-polar covalent, but we have not come yet to polar and non-polar molecules. Okay. After Vesper, it is there. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Will anything else from this class?
Sir, you were explaining something concerning the system and surrounding in which the water takes time to freeze. Could you explain that again?
No, I was, no. That what? When we say 0 degrees Celsius, I understood your question. When you say 0 degrees Celsius, we do not mean the temperature of fridge. Okay, when we say that at 0 degrees Celsius, the water will freeze, we are not saying that the surrounding should be 0 degrees Celsius. Okay?
Okay.
And what we are saying that if we measure the temperature of water, na, then this should be 0 degrees Celsius. If this is 0 degrees Celsius, then only it will freeze. Then only it will freeze. No matter what is the surrounding temperature. Surrounding temperature can be minus 100 degrees Celsius also. But if this water is not 0 degrees Celsius, it will not freeze. You understood the point?
Yeah, understood.
Anything else?
No.
No.